Gledamo sada kako je jedan od snimača Pink Floyda, Roger Waters, govorio o situaciji u Ukrajini i ostavio, čini nam se, CNN čudu.
Don't forget, 23 million Russians died protecting you and me from the Nazi menace.
Hey, and you would think the Russians would have learned their lesson from war and wouldn't have invaded Ukraine.
Well, you
fair?
With all your reading, I would suggest you, Michael, that you go away and read a bit more and then try and figure out what the United States would do if the Chinese were putting nuclear-armed missiles into Mexico and Canada.
The Chinese are too busy encircling Taiwan as we speak. Okay?
They're not encircling Taiwan. Taiwan is part of China, and that's been absolutely accepted by the whole of the international community since 1948. And if you don't know that, you're not reading enough. Go and read about it.
Okay. Did we solve anything here
this
today?
Well, we did. Well, I mean, no, we didn't.
I mean, Nancy,
you're believing your propaganda, your side's propaganda.
You're defining
but
it as
Taiwan,
propaganda.
You can't have a conversation about human rights, and you can't have a conversation about Taiwan without actually
Roger,
doing the reading.
Roger, if you're having a conversation about human rights, at the top of the list of offenders are the Chinese. Why is it always the Western world?
The top of your list?
Why is it
the
always
Chinese
the Western
didn't
world?
Invade Iraq and kill a million people in 2003. In fact, as far as I can recall, hang on a minute, who have the Chinese invaded and murdered, slaughtered?
Da, ostaje voditelj u čudu, čini nam se, da, ali ovde Waters rekao neke činjenice koje jesu
Ko prati Rogera Watersa zna da je on neko ko je izuzetno obrazovan i načitan, dakle on je neko ko je bio nekim njegovim koncertima, on je bio i u Beogradu i ostao sa njegovim projektom The Wall pre jedno 10 godina. Poruke koje on šalje su konstantne i zaista su veoma često usmerene pre svega ka kritici zapadne politike. Ne treba zaboraviti, kritikovao i naravno, i o tome govori ovaj prvi album The Wall, originalni iz 79. kritikovao je naravno totalitarizam, tada sovjetski. Tako da postoji kod njega jedan taj kontinuitet u borbi protiv totalitarne misli. I ono o čemu on govori u posljednjih 10, 15, 20 godina je da postoji jedna nova totalitarna misao koja ovog puta je na zapadu i gde on kritikuje i praktično kritikuje, na primjer, Izrael za napade na Palestince, kritikuje to jednoumlje po pitanju napada na i rusofobije, sinofobije u ovom konkretnom slučaju, kao što smo mogli da vidimo. Ali je, opet, vidite, mainstream, zapadni mainstream, čak jednog takvog legendarnog, iz jednog najvećih muzičara svih vremena, uspeva da iskritikuje, pa čak i ponekad da mu se podsmeva. I to je nešto što je vrlo slično onome što malo pre smo pričali o izveštaju Amnesty International. Isto tako, znači jedan pokušaj da se diskredituju oni koji su uljezi, je li tako? Uljezi u smislu oni koji nam kvare sreću i kvare naš pogled na ono što mi propagiramo.